So I'm going to first describe to you a more scalable version of the sense reversal algorithm. And the basic idea is to use divide and conquer. I have a hierarchical solution. That is, limit the amount of sharing to a small number of processes. Let's say a small number k of processes. And in this example, k is equal to 2. So essentially, you know, what we are saying is if you have n processes that want to do a barrier synchronization, break them up into small groups of k processes. And so we build a hierarchical solution, and a hierarchical solution obviously leads to a tree solution. And so since we have k processes competing and accomplishing a barrier among themselves, if you have n processes, then you have a log n to the base k as a number of levels in the tree in order to achieve the barrier. And in this case, what we have done is k is equal to 2. And so the number of levels, and with 8 processors, the number of levels in the tree is going to be 3. So let's talk about what happens when we arrive at a barrier. So at a micro level, the algorithm works exactly like sense reversing algorithm. And that is, these two processes, if they are sharing this data structure, a count variable and a lock sense variable, and you see that for every k processors, and in this case k being 2, every 2 processors, you have these two shared variables, a count variable and a lock sense variable. Count variable, lock sense variable, count and lock sense. And so what's going to happen, and you'll see that you have this count and lock sense variable replicated in every level of the tree, and we'll talk about how these variables are going to be used in the progression of this algorithm. So let's first talk about arriving at a barrier. So let's say that P1 has arrived at the barrier. What it is going to do is it's going to go and decrement this counter. Now, what is this counter going to be set to? Well, this counter is just for the k processes that are barrier syncing here. And k being 2, this count is going to be 2. And so this guy is going to decrement the count. And if the count is not 0, it's going to basically wait for the sense to reverse. Just like the sense reversal algorithm. So same thing is going to happen, that P1 comes here, decrements the count, and it waits for sense to reverse by spinning on this flag. Sometime later, P0 comes to the barrier, and it decrements the count. Count goes to 0. But we're not done with the barrier yet, because the barrier is for all of the processes. So what P0 is going to say is, okay, between the two of us, I know that we both have reached the barrier because the count is 0, but I have to go up and go to the next level up. And here, I'm going to decrement the count here to indicate that I've arrived at the barrier. So P0 is the one that moves up the tree. P1 is stuck here waiting for sense to reverse. P0 moves up. So remember that even though P0 has come here and decremented the count and made it 0, it doesn't flip the sense flag yet, right? Because the barrier will be done only when everybody has arrived. And therefore, all that P0 is going to do now is decrement the count, see that it is 0, then it is going to move up in the tree and go to the next level of the tree. And this data structure, which is now shared among this half of the tree, is sharing this data structure. So P0 decrements this count. And what will this count be initialized to? Again, 2, right? Because at every level, you have k processors, k being 2 in this case, arriving at a barrier. So P0 arrives here, decrements the count. Count is not 0 yet, and so it waits. So P0 is going to wait on lock sense to reverse here. P1 is waiting on lock sense to reverse here. P0 is now waiting on lock sense to reverse here because it has arrived at the barrier, but his partners are still stragglers. They have not arrived at the barrier yet.